Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome, welcome to the lucky slash unlucky episode number 13. You have a job. You have a job as a viewer to go in the comments and tell me whether you think 13 is a lucky or unlucky number. I personally think it's unlucky, but that's just me. Let's see if this is the episode that we get that first white bag in. And I know, technically, I got one. Well, see, here's the thing. It created a little bit of a controversy. People think that I should count it as a white bag, even though it wasn't white. It was a white bag item in a red bag. I don't know if to count. Whatever. We're getting it entangled here, and I don't want that to happen. All right. Let's just untangle everything and let's get straight into this. And now, whether you're going this as a serious, like you should, whether you go like episode after episode, or whether you just randomly stumbled upon this one, I have no idea. But either way, you might have already noticed that my little star count up there. Hell yeah, dude, I have 7 stars. How did that happen? I'm not gonna lie, I promised something yesterday and I didn't deliver. I promised that I would make Rogue level 20 and that I would kill him in this episode, and then I also said in the previous episode that in the episode after this one, which means the 14th one, I will make a warrior level 20 and I'll kill him as well. And then I said that in the episode after that, I'll go and I'll make him knight and I'll make him level 20 and that's gonna be it. But, it didn't kinda happen. I'm not gonna lie, I don't know if you wanted me to do this or not, but either way, I just went ahead and farmed for the knight either way, off camera. And as you can see, each of those characters have 1 star, that's why I have 7 before. Those two were starless and I had only 5. 1, 2, 6, 7. So yeah, that's pretty much that. I farmed for the knight off screen and that's that. So yeah, we have a knight now. Yeah, I wanted to quickly say a few more things. Now, there are a few things I wanted to say. One of which being the daily quest. Some people wanted me to do it, and I do agree. Hey, look at that, you get an XP booster for this. This is awesome. We'll keep our eye out for the golden sword. Actually, I might just try to farm for it and see if I get it, and if I do, then I'm gonna level mine afterwards, and if I don't, then I'm just gonna level him up today. But if I, you know, if I don't have the XP booster, I guess it doesn't matter. But yeah, I'm just gonna quickly grab all of these. Gotta not forget about the empty space over here. That's the most important thing in the whole game. Right. What else is there to say? Right. Oh, someone texted me and I didn't even notice it. Hold on a second. Was that actually a person? I know it was. It was just a stupid bot, of course. Of course it was a bot. Yeah. As I was leveling up those characters, I did find few things on the ground. I was farming in Godlands, obviously, in an UDL. And I dropped a lot of rings, especially rings from UDLs. So I have a good collection of these rings. And I think I dropped another attack ring over here. That wouldn't be too big of a deal, but I did trade a little bit as well in the previous episode. I got this kind of messed up. See, like, here's the thing. I didn't record in quite some time, so I'm a little bit, you know, off my usual sharpness, but either way, I did some trading, and I'll show the trading. I'm sure I've already showed the trading. You have probably already seen it, but basically, I sold the wisdom potions, and I basically bought a defense and a vit bot. That wouldn't be anything wrong with it, in my opinion. I think that was a pretty good trade. But also for the 2 tier 5 abilities that I have, I got free speed for each of those. And yeah, that was already a trade that I think was a little bit fishy. And then someone wanted to give me fucking tier four health ring, and I was like, you know what, just screw it. Here's the thing. I know I said I won't take donations, and I don't really know if this is a donation or not. But basically, I'll give you some backstory to this. This health ring, someone gave it to me, and the person who gave it to me was actually my friend on the Discord, and if I recall correctly, I used to help him a lot on my main account, so I guess it's like his payback a little bit. I know it's still technically like donation, and I'm not gonna take those. And yeah, while we're on the, you know, on the topic of donations and stuff, Whenever you and I get the trade, which might happen, I want you to be like honest and just, you know, don't do me any favors in the form of trading. I would appreciate it mainly because it's not fair. Like, I do appreciate you trying to give me a better offer just because I'm a YouTuber, but trust me, I can get around to it. I don't need it, okay? And just think of me as any other random person. If you find me, you know, PM me, say hi, I'll say hi. If you don't have, hey, this guy's, for example, saying hi.
Love you, bitch.
Thank you. Right, other than that, do what that guy just did and PM me if you want. But if you want to trade with me, and if you want to give me a donation, please don't. Like, it's going to make it so easy, so much easier for the both of us. Yeah, so that's that. Another thing about trading, don't do me favors in trading either. Like, for example, if an item is worth 2 def and, like, you want to sell it to me for 1 def, then, like, and, you know, it's just kind of like, it's not how it works, you know? It's not how it works. What is going on? Is there actually... Oh my god, I always fall for this shit. Yeah, other than that, I wanted to say a few more things, which was, since I lost my topic, I'm just gonna quickly talk about a different thing. That was a person who wanted me to show you my main account, and I'm pretty sure I've already made good couple hundred videos on my main account, so I'm pretty sure you can manage without it, but I'm still gonna make like a vault tour and like character tour thing, because really, why not? Why the hell not? Okay, like, seriously, I don't think it's a big deal. I can do that probably today. You'll have 2 videos today. I hope you're happy about that. Right. So we're in a snake pit now. I'm not that keen on speed, but I do have to get it because my goal is to max this guy, obviously. And well, that is one way to do it. That is a really important thing. Now, here's the thing, speed is actually pretty important. You cannot misjudge speed. You can run away from danger. And that is really, really powerful thing you can do. Speed is a powerful tool that you can use to run away from danger. And that's that. Right, so that's what I'm kind of doing. And also, obviously, you know, maxing is a good thing. And there's like an assassin skin I kind of want to, so hey, why not? Also, I wanted to quickly say that I'm on board with all the new updates that happened, all this Easter stuff. And also, I have a few little ideas for this episode in particular. I got 2 tier 2 attack rings. I don't know how this works, but still. So basically, because it's Easter and all, there are doubled egg drops in Godlands. You basically have twice the chance to get an egg drop from Godlands than you would usually have. I guess it goes for every dungeon, and you can get like the rare ones. Maybe there's a double chance for that as well. I am not sure. I have not read the patch notes yet. But either way, from what was brought to my attention, you basically have a higher chance to get a pet. And a lot of you wanted me to get a better pet, and that's what I'm gonna do. I will get a better pet. And but I will not, and I'll repeat this one for the people who are stubborn, I will not feed this one. And why is that? Well, because this is not the family I want. I want humanoid. Why do I want humanoid? Because whichever humanoid egg I get, I can start feeding that, even though the second ability is not magic heal. And I can what I can do is then I can wait for a magic heal, and then I can start feeding that pet. But by that point, I will already have a good enough heal pet. The reason why I do this is because humanoid eggs always have heal. This is something that was brought to my attention many, many times by you guys, and I do appreciate that, but I already knew it. For those people who don't know, which I'm guessing most of you don't know at this point, I actually made a newbie's guide back a couple years ago. So yeah, you can go watch that if you want. I'll try to leave a link to it in the description, but if I remember to actually do that. Now, basically, why would I go for a humanoid? Obviously, you always have heal, which means that even if the first pet you try to level up doesn't have MP heal, just keep opening humanoid eggs, and trust me, pet soon enough will have an MP heal there too, which will be just fantastic. And I'm getting completely raped by these guys, and I don't want to get raped. Right, so that's kind of that. Also, I know that there's like a new dungeon. I think it's like a temple. I'm not even sure what the hell it's called, but it looks really cool. I saw someone video made on it. Some YouTuber made a video on it. I'm not sure who that guy is right now. I know it wasn't JGD, but it was someone else. Oh, either way. Boom, speed. Thank you for that. Right. Well, I saw a video from some people who were doing that dungeon, and it looks really cool, and I would like to give it a shot as well. The boss kind of looks hardcore, actually, because the boss does a lot of damage. At least there he has a face he does a lot of damage in, so we'll be careful for that. And obviously, there is a new event that comes along with it, which is pretty awesome. I want to give that event a try, but yeah, not exactly right now. Right, I had an idea. This might actually be it. Yo, this is the area in which the new event spawns. Look at this. I have never seen something so pretty in my whole life. Okay, that's not exactly true. Just look how beautiful this is. Leviathans, get the fuck out of here. I wanna embrace this feeling. Look at this. We didn't have a new area in Realm for so long. This is just... Ah, man, it's so nice. It's so nice to see things. Why are there so many Leviathans? What's going on? My god. Quickly gonna mention a few things. I'm not sure if it was the previous episode, but either way, someone left a comment, and I quote, "I would literally pay for a 30-minute special." And you know what, guy? You know what, you dude? You don't have to pay me, I'll do it for free. So this one is gonna be a little bit longer episode. And that's mainly because you guys deserve it, in my opinion. You guys deserve it. And if that isn't what you want, then too bad. But because I don't have too much time, I've decided on a little bit of a thing, and that is I'm not gonna skip. And what I'm not gonna skip? Why would I not skip boring sprite wolves, right? Well, here's the thing. I'm not gonna do sprite wolves today, this episode, and I'm doing it for a simple reason. Since episode 2, I've been doing a lot of sprite wolves, and I think it's time we kinda take a break from sprite wolves. And my plan was to... I see your videos, thank you, even though your grammar is completely messed up and out of place, I still love you, my friend. Either way, we've done enough sprite wolves in my opinion. So we could do that, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Paramount attack ring. I mean, is this something that I should feel bad about taking? You know what? I'm gonna take it. Why not? It's not that huge of an upgrade. And to be honest, you know, about the tier 4 health ring that I took yesterday. Yeah, speaking about not taking donations. This isn't exactly like a donation. I mean, it's a tier 4 attack ring. Come on. Yeah. To be fair, about the tier 4 health ring that someone gave me, I would probably just farm for it anyways, and I would buy it. He basically saved me a little bit of time. I would get that same exact ring myself a little bit later on, so that's not a huge difference. But yeah, we have a... Wait, I actually want to keep this for now, because it's not that bad. But yeah, why not say a few more things. One of which, there's boss. That's cool. Yeah, I want to just quickly say a little plan I have for today. Today's episode, I will try to max my knight. Not max, I'll try to level up my knight. See how that goes. Might just go well. My idea was that I could probably see if there's a good fame train, and if there is, then I could probably try to speed it up and just level him up there. And maybe, just maybe, if there isn't good enough Godlands, I could just try to just skip that one thing. Because again, I do not have that much time. And yes, I actually am recording. You are welcome in case you wanted to be on YouTube. And if you didn't want to be on YouTube, that's too bad for you. But still, if there is good enough Godlands fame train going on, then I will not. Then I will speed up. And if there isn't, I'm going to skip. Either way, I want to get that level 20 knight in this episode, and that's it. Also, you people are kind of sick of my wizard, which I can understand. I mean, it's like the 12th episode in a row in which I've played him. So, I guess I understand why you guys are a little bit sick of him. So am I, to be honest. But you have to understand, I want to get somewhere. And since I'm not doing Spreadable this episode, I don't have anything else to play. I can obviously play my knight after I level it, after I'm le- after I level him up, level him up. After I level my knight up, I could probably play him. But what I found out about knights is that, God, I'm completely off my words today. But yeah, what I found out about knights a long time ago is that they're not all too great in Godlands. Now, don't get mad at me. If you have a pet, sure, that they can be great. But see, that's the thing, right? I don't have a pet. So, all right, let's just see if the same thing that happened to me before will happen. But I don't think it did. Yeah, I got swarmed by those two guys to the side, and I just got completely wrecked. Hey, look at that! Awesome. You got another speed potion. Speed is crucial. I don't know how many times I have to say that. I did say that I'm not too keen on it, but that's because I don't like farming for it. But either way, if I see any lying around, I will get them. Don't you worry. So yeah, as I was saying before, knights are kind of hard to, well, do Godlands farming with, because, you know, you take a bit of damage here, you take a bit of damage there, you know, you got that close range, it's not ideal. And, well, wizard is just so much better than knight, well, in this early stage of the game anyways. So my opinion was I could just farm on my wizard a hell of a lot. Godlands, try to get some of them eggs, you know, and try to really lift off with this account. But I think that's pretty good. I think I'm doing a good job. Tell me if you think I'm doing a good job so far, because I certainly think I'm doing a good job. Am I not? Tell me. I don't think I am. I don't think I'm not doing a bad job. Okay, I got lost. I don't think I'm doing too bad of a job. There we go. Right. So let's move on. Yeah. So should probably get on that leveling up part. But yeah, I'm not twice happy about leveling up and all, because leveling up is boring. You might actually try to spend one speed on buying a golden sword, because I don't want to do it the old-fashioned way. I want this to be, you know, interesting. And I feel like leveling up my knight, speed up time, you know, time lapse and all, that could add interesting spark to this episode. And I would really like to do that, but you know, it can take like half an hour to get level 20, especially without a pet, which I am kind of like right now. So, you know, my opinion is like things are not as easy as they should be. Either way, we do have an attack ring, so let's just use that, because I know there's gonna be someone like, you have an attack ring and you don't use it. I will use it right now. Boom, boom, there we go. We got another speed. Amazing. Right, so there we go. You dude, I used my attack ring. But here's the thing. I use attack rings mainly because, well, they're good for attack. What else the fuck can I say? But, yeah, this ring gives me health. And if you didn't notice, I'm gonna show you again. Although I can't really right now because I don't have full HP. But here's the thing, right? Here's the thing. If you take that ring down and you put it back on, that means you will lose 120 health. Because, well, here's the thing, you take the ring down, I have full HP, I can show you now. It will, well, basically, right now I don't have the plus 120 HP that I would have before, and now if I put it back on, it just starts loading up again. And I don't want to do that during a boss fight, because, well, genuinely, you don't want to be caught off guard without HP, but still, you know, sometimes, you know, bosses have minions and, I don't know. I just prefer to have HP other than attack, but I still want to have attack, just in the rare case that there's like a boss that I can actually use the attack ring on, such as these. We have a knight, right? We have a knight. We don't have a knight. Well, shit. I just realized I'm a total scrub compared to these guys. And this assassin is my fan as well. This is some messed up shit right there. If I get something, by the way, I am going to scream. I'm not gonna scream. I just realized that's a terrible idea because my mom is asleep. I don't want to wake up my mom, you know. So that's that. Yeah. Okay. This is, in my opinion, a boss I could use my attack ring on. Quick tip: when you're doing the final boss, be in the middle of the group. You won't have a problem taking the shots and the zombies. It's a general tip. It's not too bad of a tip. Yeah. Right. So here we go. You got something. What is that? It's a Vitbot. Is Vitbot important? Did I say I'm gonna try to sell Vitality for defense? I did say that, didn't I? Well, shit. Better get on that. But yeah, other than that, I don't think I really need Vit. And I know what you're thinking. I know exactly what you're thinking. But Vit is important. You don't have a pet. What are you trying to do? You don't try to drink vitality potions, and you need a lot of regeneration, or at least a better pet, which I don't have right now. And I do admit that seems kind of silly, but to me, it feels like, you know, vitality is just never did too great of a difference. Whatever. Okay, I'm gonna do a small little cut. I'll try to see if anyone is selling the tier 7 sword, and if they are, then I'm gonna do a little bit of a speed up with some nice music in the background for you guys. And if no one is selling the tier 7 sword, the banana sword, if no one's selling the banana sword on Real Might, then I'm just gonna cut it and I'll have level 29. I will play him a little bit, I promise we'll play him a little bit. So yeah, I'll see you after I check Real Might, or after my knight gets level 20. See you after that. Well, okay, so I'm back, and it would appear that I do not need A, an XP booster, or B, I don't even need to fucking be here, because this one has a terrible, terrible roll, and no. Bad night, go away. Don't come back, you piece of shit. Be ashamed of yourself. Nah, I'm sorry. This one really just took the cake for like the worst roll ever. Cause I had minus 20, like 4 health, and I am not putting up with that. So instead, I'm gonna re-roll him. It doesn't take forever to get this done. So what? It doesn't matter. Let's just go again and see if we have a better luck. There we go. That's a lot better. Whew. Okay. So, it took me 2 tries. And by the way, if you have no idea why I killed the first one, I'll try to break it down to you as good as I can. But basically, you got 8 stats. And with each level you get, those stats will change. And how they change is basically completely random. And, well, I don't really care about these 6 stats down here, but I do care about health and mana. And I had minus 21 health back then, in the previous night. So, this one has minus 1, but that's as close to average as I want it to be. So, what I'm gonna do is quickly, I'll tell in chat, slash, tell Mr. Eyeball, and I'll tell him stats, and he, if you can see that, he tells me exactly minus 1 HP, plus 4 MP, plus attack, plus speed, plus dex, plus vis, plus vit, minus vis. Yeah, that is already a good enough roll for me. But either way, this is how you should probably roll your characters. You shouldn't just get stuck with something that doesn't have a good roll. I do suggest you watch out for that right now. And yeah, there we go. So, I have my knight. The knight is born. There we go. I hope you enjoyed the little montage, guys. Now, I do have an attack, but I don't think I should drink it on the knight. Neither should I drink to the pot. I'll drink a speed, why not? And the vet, because... Although, no, I'm gonna keep the vet. I'm gonna quickly hop on my wizard and drink the death pot on him. I don't think I really need anything else to Bbye. I don't think I need anything. I should definitely upgrade my archer, but again, for as long as I don't have that Doombo, I don't think it matters. But yeah, so I know I recorded around 20 minutes before with just the priest, with just the wizard, and I kind of want to jump on my knight right now and try the farming on my knight a little bit. Maybe like, I'll give it like 10 more minutes tops. I don't want to make this an hour long video, but I will make it a little bit longer because I think that's what you guys want. But yeah, before I do that, I'm gonna quickly grab some health potions because I will probably need them. I have no idea myself how good a knight will be in Godlands, because I didn't have a knight in my Godlands for a while. This is the first knight I have on this account, so will definitely be interesting, but we'll have to see how good he is. So I hope I'm doing a favor to the one dude who wanted to be a longer episode. Hope I'm doing you a favor, and I hope you have got this far, dude. Okay, so right, this knight is pretty dope. But again, as I said, I don't think he'll be that good for Godlands, as my wizard is anyways. But he. Well, not just my knight, but any other knight, really, is really good for dungeons of every kind, pretty much. So, for example, Sprite Wolves will be easily done with him now. Like, look at this, just ease, right? But you need to get close enough to do that. But, yeah, I'll mainly just do dungeons on this guy, not exactly farming Godlands and stuff. And, of course, you don't need that much defense on him. I mean, seriously, he has quite a lot without any extra, but still, I feel like it's important to get at least a little bit on him. Again, just my opinion though. And the damage, obviously, it's gonna be a huge help. I'll try to do some dungeons on him next episode, I promise. He's gonna be awesome. What else can I do? This little lonely constructor, I have no idea how the hell you got separated, but you are going to die, my friend. Now, here's the thing, right? I've got 3 ghost gods on my tail. I can't take him on. The thing I learned a couple, like, years ago is that all the trick in a book for when you're not. You can drag him. I'm trying to find a tree right now, by the way. You can drag him to, like, a stone or, like, a tree. And, well, I had to find one first, but really possible that there isn't any. Oh wow, there's an egg. What the hell just what's happening? Wait, why is he running? Whoa, what's going on? I'm so confused. What the hell is going on? I was about to show you a cool trick and then this thing appeared. Like, what the? Okay, bunny, I'm not gonna hurt you, bunny. Don't worry, I will. Ha. Okay, I guess I won't. I this guy's just running away from me. That's literally it. I can't catch up to him. I am. Oh. Oh. Okay. So is that okay? I know that I've seen this before, but obviously I don't have a chance to do it myself yet. So yeah, actually this is quite a hard thing. I don't want to get completely stomped on. That would suck. But yeah, this is gonna be interesting. I haven't done this yet, so it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be a lot of fun to do this. It might be my thumbnail, who knows. What? He disappeared! What? Are we on a hunt? Hunt for them eggs? Is there more? Dude, I am so confused right now. Oh well. Here's a hermit god, I can do that. Probably. After this hermit god, there should be like another egg then, right? Because, like, it's just like an egg hunt, you know? This is interesting, I like it. It's really interesting. Yeah, we didn't get anything. I'm gonna actually stay in here in the realm because I wanna make sure that the thing that's gonna happen is not something I actually miss. But, well, it seems to be that way right now. This is weird. This is honestly weird. Like, I have no idea what's going on. That the bunny who just kind of stood there and ran away from me. Definitely interesting. But what? Someone's saying things. I don't know. Oh, there's another one. Another Easter egg. Look at this. This is so cool. I have never seen this before. Alright. This is interesting. Oh, what the? Okay, he was somewhere up here, wasn't he? I'm gonna go there myself. I'm an explorer. You guys cannot stop me. I know where it was. It was somewhere ahead of me. I'll go there myself if I have to. This egg that I'm going towards is actually a lot prettier than the one we've just killed. I don't know how that works. I guess there may be like random sprites. It'll be interesting to see how that works. But yeah, I kind of thought that the... So let me get this straight. So you get the mountain temple from the new event that's in Godlands or wherever in the realm, and you get this doesn't drop in a dungeon, does it? This is weird. This is definitely weird. A lot of people are trying to kill the Oasis giant because they don't know where exactly the egg is. They know that it was here, but they don't know where exactly it is. But we know. Well, we don't really know, but we almost know. So I'm gonna try to go there myself. Oh, and there it was. Right here. Well, I guess I was kind of off. Yeah, I'll teleport to this guy. See, I have no idea how many do you have to kill. Maybe there's like a chance that each egg has that it will get the bunny to spawn or whatever the hell it spawns. That's interesting. Look, it's all the way on the beach. Not this bunny though. I don't. Are you supposed to mean anything? I don't. I'm just. Surprised. Oh, nice with the knight. Yep, just made him right now. But I'm as confused as I can possibly be. You know what, I'm gonna kill the stupid bunny. I don't even care if this is an hour long video. I want this bunny to die. I want to have it recorded too, because I have never done that before. It'd be so cool if the bunny dropped the temple as well, but I'm guessing that would be a little bit overpowered. So yeah, too bad we won't do that today, but I promise you we will do the mountain temple one day on this channel, and I'm gonna be on a wizard and it's gonna be awesome. Can't wait. It's gonna be great. And I missed everyone. Nice. Okay, let's see. So by my understanding, another egg should spawn somewhere in the realm, but again, that's just me. I could be completely wrong. That is... Oh, there he is! Oh my god, what the... What a beefcake, look at him. Oh my god, I'm confused. What the hell did you do to me? Oh my god, what the fuck? Oh, why do you keep confusing me? He's not fat! Oh, is that immune to stun? Oh, yes he is. Yes he is! Oh, watch out, the beefcake's attacking! The beefcake's attacking, people! What does he drop? I have no clue. I'm so scared to go forwards. Oh my god. That was so fun. What the hell? Look at this beautiful area it spawned. Is this an egg shape thing? I don't know. I don't know. It's in the middle of Godlands too. I have no idea what the hell he drops. I'm gonna try to ask it. What does he drop? See if anyone answers me, because that would be an interesting thing to know. What does he drop? No one is responding to that. Yeah, I guess it's a question for you then, because I am too fucking lazy to actually find it myself. But there is one more thing I want to do. One more thing I want to do before anything else goes down. Aww. I guess I'm gonna completely miss out on this one. I guess if he spawns the... Yeah, he spawned the ice cave. Ugh, this must be like an hour long already. I don't wanna skip this either though. This is an actually interesting dungeon, you know, but I don't know. Maybe if there's like a lot of leeches, maybe I'll skip it. I'm not sure. Maybe this won't even be in the video anymore. Who the hell knows? But I sure as hell don't. So that's one thing. For sure. Seems to be doing pretty well. I do have a small chance to get loot. I mean, especially with a weapon like this, I can definitely get loot. Just depends if I get lucky and or not, but you know, it might actually just be me. This is kinda sad. We get all the way at the end, we get an ice cave. It kinda sucks. Alright, well, I don't wanna skip this because this dungeon is actually interesting. At least it's nice to look at. It's nice to look at. You guys won't mind an hour long episode, will ya? Come on, man. The situation clearly calls for it. That's my excuse for everything. My excuse for everything. The situation calls for it. Yeah, so we can just do this really slowly now. We don't have to rush it. I'm glad I got to record the bunny thing, because my god, what a beefcake that guy was. What the hell? What a buffed up bunny. Yeah, I love when they add new things to Realm. So much fun. Just to fuck around. I mean, seriously, that bunny though. Oh man. Right. So there's actually... It would appear that there's quite a lot of people clearing. You know, dumb people here and people up there. There's a lot of leechers at the same time, but you know, when there aren't that many leechers, come on. Leechers are everywhere in every dungeon. See if you get lucky. We didn't get lucky. You know, I was unstable, but the stun still could have went the direction that he was in, so I tried to stun him, but of course, I wasn't lucky enough. Because debuffs do suck. Yeah, okay. This is kind of going slow now. I might speed it up, I might not, I don't know. I have no idea what I'll do with this thing. I showed off a little bit, I feel like. Oh, wait, it's actually already here. Oh, never mind. Never mind, I was about to say I'm gonna go on the leech pen and just wait, but I don't have to do that anymore. Look how many people there are. This is gonna be... Oh, this is gonna be a short ice cave. I can smell it. I can run through him! Haha. Follow me if you dare. Oh, don't do what I just did, by the way. Whenever he first spawns in the head, you can do that, but just don't do that. I'm a cocky motherfucker. That's because I know what I'm doing, but you, if you don't know what you're doing, I highly encourage you to just not do anything. Did we get something? We didn't, of course we didn't. Why was I even here? Oh well, anyways, this was definitely an interesting episode, you have to admit. This episode was a hell of a lot of fun. I certainly had fun. We have a nice night going on, which is awesome. I'm gonna farm a lot of health pots on him. I'm gonna quickly just say one more time, how I move around potions. For the people that, like, didn't know, but either way, if you have a potion, you can just drag a normal item over it, and you can just move it wherever you want to move it. So yeah, if you didn't know that by accident, then yeah, now you know. Anyways, we have a knight. We drank a few potions. Whoops. We did a new event thing going on. That was awesome. I had a lot of fun. The farming for the humanoid egg continues. My knight is alive now, and that's all from me. See you later, guys, and bye bye.